The death toll in Israel is now over 1,200 people. In Gaza, 1,500 have reportedly lost their lives since Hamas terrorists massacred innocent civilians. They targeted young people at a music festival, the elderly at home, babies in their cots. I'm joined now by Palestinian activist and author Dr Randa Abdel-Fattah. Doctor, thank you so much for joining me. What is your reaction to what occurred in Israel on Saturday?
I wasn't surprised. Anybody who's been paying attention to the suffering of Palestinians now would know that there is no people who can withstand the kind of intense subjugation and oppression, ethnic cleansing, settler colonialism that they have, and just acquiesce to their suffering and oppression. At some point, Palestinians, like all people, are going to demand freedom and resist occupation. And they have tried every avenue of political means, every avenue of peaceful resistance, and every single step has been blockaded to them. Particularly in Gaza, when you have a 16-year siege, land, sea, water, blockade, the United Nations said that it would be uninhabitable by 2020, and it's 2023 now. So those conditions are a powder keg, and every Palestinian has been saying for years now, this is an unsustainable situation for Palestinians. So there was no surprise at what has happened, just extreme tragedy that we have allowed this to happen as an international community because of the lack of will to start imposing international law and treat Israel as a state that should not be afforded the luxury of impunity in the way that it subjugates Palestinians and oppresses them.
You say one of the reasons for the atrocities that occurred in Israel on Saturday is the oppression of Palestinian people. Do you separate Hamas from Palestine?
No, I think that's it's a question that doesn't really make sense because...
Well, Hamas is a terrorist organisation. That's how we identify them there. And there are innocent Palestinians, absolutely, that have suffered, as have there been innocent Israelis that have suffered. But Hamas is a terrorist organisation.
What's the function of your question, though? But what we need to talk about the cause of this here. A lot of media and analysts keep making this about Hamas versus Israel. Let's get back to the nature of who is Israel. It is a state that was imposed on a majority indigenous population through ethnic cleansing, through massacres, through depopulation and refugee crisis. It's a settler colony, it's an apartheid state by every human rights organisation in the world. Hamas does not represent all of Palestinians, but every single Palestinian, whether from the West Bank, from Gaza, the refugees, the Israeli Arabs who are discriminated against, are all wanting freedom and liberation.
Okay, there has been violence from both sides over many, many years.
Wrong.
Absolutely, there has been.
Not equal.
Over many, many years.
It's not a situation of parity.
What occurred on Saturday by Hamas was beyond anything we have ever seen before. There is no way you can sit there and not condemn the actions of Hamas. Do you condemn the beheading of babies?
First of all, the beheading story has been actually refuted by Israeli authorities, so you are repeating and propagating propaganda.
It has not
there.
Been refuted
it
by
has.
Israeli authorities.
Yes, it has.
The US, Blinken is there. He has seen verified images. There are independent journalists who have verified the existence of images of babies who have been beheaded and burnt babies. Are you trying to say that is propaganda?
Yeah, I am, because actually today that image of a burnt baby was exposed as AI intelligence. And can I just say something? Let's say that these atrocities were committed, which are of course must be condemned and are atrocities. Let's say that they were committed, and we know that atrocities were committed. Why is it that only Jewish babies matter? Why is it that you're only taking an interest now?
No.
Why did the clock start on October 7th when babies have literally been murdered and massacred?
You were on Q&A 2 years ago. The fight has been covered for years.
I was on Q&A only because there were rockets fired into Israel. Come and bring me onto your show when Palestinians are being displaced from their homes, when they are being
That is happening right now.
When settlers
Israel is retaliating. They are telling civilians to get out. They are not doing what Hamas did to them.
Are you telling me that white phosphorus on Gaza at the moment is acceptable? It's a war crime. That displacement
of populations... You want to talk about war crimes?
Even the way that
you... Do you want to talk about the rape of innocent women? What happened on Saturday, you must condemn.
I've already condemned it. Why are you questioning my humanity here? Do you think I'm a monster that I would not condemn
this? You have defended Hamas in the past. Well, you have also sat in a panel with a Hamas terrorist. You have also retweeted a tweet that is calling for the destruction of Israel. Do you want Israel eradicated? I've looked at your past. I am asking you because you have said and done things in the past. Do you stand by them?
What you're saying here is nonsense.
You are How is that nonsense?
Because I am trying to paint Palestinians and me, people who are just demanding basic dignity and freedom.
You are ignoring. I have immense sympathy for innocent Palestinian civilians. I shed tears when I saw kids in hospital in Gaza that were the victim of this. I
feel. God bless white women's tears. God bless white women's tears.
Where were your tears? Now you're attacking my race.
Where were your tears last
week? My tears have existed for any atrocity that has occurred to any child in the world. I've got you on here to ask you about Hamas, about those atrocities. I have acknowledged Palestinian suffering. But I'm here to talk about what Hamas did to Israeli babies.
I have already addressed that, and I said if we are going to stop,
you're justifying it. How can you justify it?
I did not justify anything.
You said the reason Saturday occurred is because your people have been oppressed. If your people have been oppressed, if they are occupied, wage a war. If you feel justified in waging a war, fight Israeli soldiers with guns. Don't behead babies.
You do.
You're laughing at me.
Because you do realise that there is a siege in Gaza where not even food is allowed in.
The Israeli government sending out warnings to civilians. Yes, this is their retaliation.
Are you here to scream at me or interview me?
I'm not screaming at you at all, but I also can't let you spout things on here that
you're not letting me
this
talk.
This is my show. Okay, talk.
Okay, so can I talk? First of all, you're saying, why don't we fight Israeli soldiers? You do realise that Palestinians are under military occupation.
Absolutely.
You do realise that there is a siege there. We do not have a standing army. You do realise that Israel is armed to the teeth. Talk to me about that. Talk to me about the settler violence that happens on a daily basis, the murder of Palestinian children by Israelis. Talk to me about occupation. Talk to me about the siege on Gaza. It is uninhabitable. Water that is not drinkable, and yet Israeli settlers and Israelis enjoy swimming pools. They enjoy the accessing free water.
If you genuinely feel aggrieved, and I acknowledge there are people on both sides who genuinely feel aggrieved, my heart breaks for you. Yeah.
I'm coming here as someone.
Do you condemn Hamas then? Tell me that.
I have already said that I condemn the violence that Hamas perpetrated.
But Hamas as an organisation, organisation, will you condemn them?
I don't see them as a terrorist organisation. Can you
Did you not see the vision of them shooting down people like animals, and you will not condemn the organisation that perpetrated that violence on innocent people?
What is the purpose of a terrorist label here? Then let's talk about Israel's terrorism against Palestinians. Israel is the occupying power. It is the settler colony. It is the one that has the international human rights organisations declaring that it is practising apartheid here. Why are we not focusing on the perpetrators of violence here? And why are we focusing on the victim, on the occupied?
I think the Jews understand oppression better than anyone. I want to show you this image from Monday night at the rally and what was said at this pro-Palestinian rally. Take a look. They say, F the Jews and gas the Jews.
I didn't hear anything.
You're telling me you haven't seen or heard any of those images?
I've seen those images, and I heard that there was a tiny minority who said F the Jews, which is disgusting.
That was
It has been condemned. It was a small minority.
It was
the majority of the protesters, including Jewish activists there, have said that it was a majority peaceful protest.
I'm questioning the right of Hamas, an organisation you will not condemn as a group, of killing innocent babies, children,
women. I have
women.
Condemned
You
what
retweeted
done.
A tweet that said, Israel does not have a right to exist.
Correct. No state legally has a right to exist, Erin. That is a creative way that Israel is trying to justify its settler occupation. There's actually no legal...
Israel does not have a right to exist.
Yes.
That says to me you are saying eradicate Israel. Are you saying that's not the case?
First of all, states do not, under law, have a right to exist.
So this is a technical legal.
Don't tell me that we are not interested in getting to the root cause of this matter. Bring international law in. Let them investigate Hamas, but let them investigate Israel too.
I condemn any violence on any side that kills innocent civilians every day of the week. Read my column in the Daily Telegraph today. I wrote about that. I said Israel must follow the rules of war, despite the crimes and the atrocities committed against them by Hamas.
And
I stand by that. I condemn violence against anyone that is innocent.
The only way Israel is going to be able to follow the rules of law is if it is denied the impunity in which the international community has given it, and if politicians and the media start doing their jobs. I promise you it's not complicated.
You have had a fair say, and I thank you very much for coming on my show.
Thank you.
Thank you.